just like the smell of crisp, warm linen.
I don't know whether to throw my money away on Neptune's ladder 12 to 1. Or play safe and throw it all away on the second favorite.
Ironing is one of the few housewifely skills I find I can take to.
Has they ironed my tie yet?
No, I'll do it next.
Ah.
Mind you, it worries me a bit that I've started to like ironing because I'm terrified that it means that I'm tampering with my hormone balance and I'm going to start going out in long eyelashes.
Just give it a quick run over.
It looks as though it has been run over.
There's a lot to wear in that tie. It's amazing what wear there is in a tie. Him from Snackball Street hung himself with a tie.
So that's where you got it. You haven't undone the knot.
No. I bought that brand new down the market to go with a brown suit I had.
When have you ever had a suit that went with anything brand new?
I have not always been scruffy.
Well, you have mostly.
Oh, I mostly. I used to put the glamour on sometimes for a bird, but it didn't get me anywhere.
Why?
Well, it took me 52 weeks to pay for the suit, and the bird only stayed a fortnight.
She stayed a fortnight? Looks like a taxi driver.
A taxi driver with a whistle and a fag.
A lion tamer.
For deaf lions. A lollipop man, that's what he is, a lollipop man.
Get on your feet, come on, it's train time.
Train time?
Yes, wake up, Batman. We're just in time for the grand opening if you get your skates on.
What grand opening?
I'm nearly missed it. But I had no idea it was happening until I ran into Arnold Watts.
You ran into Arnold Watts?
No, I'm telling you.
I told you he was a taxi driver.
I ran into him on foot.
You can't win with taxi drivers. They miss you with a vehicle, they get out and trample you to death.
I stopped to pass the time of day and he told me all about it. So will you kindly unplug your iron and let's be on our way.
Tell me all about what?
About the grand opening, she saw. I rushed back home for me railway memorabilia and I dashed straight round here. Come on, we're going to be late.
Where are they dragging us off to now?
To a piece of history.
Hey, you've not been going out with Mrs. Allsop again.
I've never been out with Mrs. Allsop.
I should think not. Even Mr. Allsop, God rest him, really went out with Mrs. Allsop.
This is a piece of our heritage I'm getting into.
Steam preservation's reopening of the old railway line from Keithley to Oxenholm.
Here with real engines, you lucky little man, Steam. Do you hear me, Steam?
I can't. I've got a spout.
Oh, impression. Come on.
No, I can't. He's ironing me tie.
Oh, he's finished your tie. Come on, give him his tie.
Oh, no, that smashing tongue.
I think so, with all modesty.
Oh, come on, Batman, we're nearly there.
But nearly where? That's the trouble with the age of steam, Foggy. People have to walk nearly everywhere.
Dear, ask them to walk a couple of miles.
Hey, up streaky, we ain't talking on legs like a giraffe.
Oh, get a move on.
Just because you've got crop your food way up in the trees, that don't mean to say we're all built like it.
He's got a point, Foggy.
I'm well aware he's got a point. Those damn trousers, it's the biggest wonder we can't all see it.
Trousers?
Well, they put railway engines in smarter sheds than those.
10 miles by your legs has got to be 15 by these.
We haven't done anywhere near 10 miles.
These legs are more your kilometre size. God, I've gone metric.
You find anybody to tell me what's wrong with my trousers.
From his trousers?
It was a railway engine whistle. I promised you a treat.
Oh, it's been a real treat.
Come on, Luke. Come on, Luke.
Oh, yes. How marvelous. Well worth walking miles to see under the railway line.
It's been restored.
Oh, great. A bit of old restored railway line.
Don't tell me this lunatic has brought us all this way just to look at this.
You haven't seen anything yet.
My feelings exactly.
Steady, Foggy. You keep pouring on the excitement like this. It's more than flesh and blood can stand.
I bring you to a piece of history where all you can do is show contempt.
I wouldn't say that's all we can do. Whistle through his trousers.
She's coming. They must be testing her. What a stroke of luck.
Oh, Fab, we're going to see you book the train.
Yes, you are. And you'll be grateful. You are about to see a steam engine. A steam engine? Lovingly restored. The official reopening of the line, and we can be part of it. We can be among the passengers on this first historic journey.
As long as we don't have to walk.
This is a big occasion. That's why I would have liked you to get dressed up a bit. However, if you stick close to me, I think we'll be all right. I'm wearing the L&ER cap. What's the matter with you? Can't you work up a bit of enthusiasm? Can't you feel your spine tingling with pride?
I can feel the ache in my spine from all that walking.
Mine's in my knee. I can feel my knee stiff with pride.
Have you no regard for the poetry of steam? Do you round that bend is a pretty little village and the cutest railway station you've ever seen. Don't tell me there's nothing stirs inside you at the thought of it.
Will it ever?
Here she comes. Oh, look at this. What a stroke of luck to be on the bridge. The time they've given her a test run. Oh, isn't she beautiful? That's no diesel. Oh, look at that. That's steam. Here we are to see it. A grandstand view.
Ada used to wait at table.
which is more than you've ever done. She did it once and picked off the boat as gruff as him.
But there doesn't seem to be a towel.
Oh, I am sorry about that. And I apologize also for the absence of bath salts and aftershave. Only a bit of wash.
Oh, no, it's bad for my skin. No, anyway, I have a feeling that washing today is going to be a waste of time.
He won't be told.
That's what they said about me, Uncle Arthur.
When?
Before he left for South Africa to make his fortune.
What happened?
Come as far as Southampton and was knocked down by a tram. He ended up marrying the driver's sister.
Why the driver's sister?
I suppose the driver was already married.
You know, Foggy not only goes filthy old train spugging, he also goes filthy old nut spugging as well. No!
You know, for the genuine enthusiast, there's something tremendously atmospheric about places like this.
Yeah, I thought I smelled something. Smells like rat pee to me.
Old nostalgia.
Is it? Oh, well, something must have nipped in nostalgia that nipped out.
At least we hope it's nipped out again.
But it's sad to see the place in this condition.
What are you talking about? Old railway sheds were always in this condition. Tacked.
There's no talking about being tacked.
They were built in this condition.
You could be right, Foggy.
Who builds places in this condition?
Your local authorities, mostly. It's called progress. It used to take years to build a slum, and nowadays they're building them practically ready to wear.
You know, we could spend our weekends restoring all this.
Oh, I can't wait! Oh, he really knows how to grab a fellow's imagination.
Well, I suppose you'd just let it fall down.
Who's gonna miss it?
What about future generations?
But in the past few years, this old sulphur has had a great deal to do with future generations. By the feel of them springs, I reckon there's been a few railway enthusiasts through here.
Now, you can scoff if you like, but there's nothing I'd like better than to come here for a few hours every week. Just lie on this sofa with a railway timetable and a flask of tea. Listen to the trains go by. Oh, luxury. So, she's come back. Oh, she's all come down the atmosphere. We're in for a treat now. No, I can't resist at all.
Easy, I just want this. no, it couldn't have been that. Maybe it was this. Hang on.
Will you let those levers alone before you...
Thank you. Thank you. Friendly crowd.
This weekend's UK TV drama Hitchcock Classics. Suspicion is at 7 o'clock.